The Pearl of Africa, located at the edge of the equator on the eastern side of the African continent, nestling between the two arms of the Great Rift Valley. Landlocked Uganda derives her name from the Buganda Kingdom, which was formed by the British in the year 1890.
Years of British rule are ending.
Uganda gained her independence in 1962, maintaining its Commonwealth membership.
Uganda is independent.
Since independence, Uganda has had 8 presidents, including Kabaka Mutesa II, Dr. Milton Obote I, General Idi Amin Dada, Yusuf Lule, Godfrey Binah Issa, Paul Mwanga, Obote II, Tito Okello Lutwa, and currently His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni. Uganda's capital, Kampala, is a big commercial city for nearly all Eastern Central Africa. It is a hub of activity as people weave in and out of the modern city buildings that have increasingly sprung up as a result of the rising economic growth and economic stability. Also, originally known as the City of Seven Hills, it commands great views and tremendous beauty and is home to several luxurious 4 to 5 star hotels, thus guaranteeing 5 star accommodation facilities to visiting tourists. The people work hard during the day and equally play hard at night, so few cities across the African continent can rival the nightlife of Kampala. Nightlife in Kampala is vibrant and intoxicating.
Much love and God bless. Thanks to all my fans out there. I love y'all.
The city is a melting pot, bringing together people from the country's diverse ethnic groups. Uganda has a cultural contrast of over 50 tribes. This diversity has created a richness in culture, each group having its own unique traditions and rituals. In Buganda, the introduction ceremony known as Kwanjula is rife with Chigano traditions, where a man is officially introduced to his fiancée's family. Music and dance form an integral part of culture. Courtship and marriage provide an opportunity for the people to show off their talent. And in northern Uganda, the Agwara dance is a colorful and spectacular dance. The Echtaguro is a dance which comes from the Ankole region. Oral tradition has it that the dance was performed to demonstrate the love the Ankole people have for their cattle, evidenced by the dance movements and instruments. In spite of this diversity, the people of Uganda are warm and friendly.
Ugandan people and the country, they've really blown me away. It's been a hell of a trip.
But it's my first time in Uganda, and it's a special country, and I've had a lovely time. Met wonderful people.
The Constitution guarantees freedom of religion. All religions are expected to be registered with the government, and some that are considered cults are restricted. Uganda's tourism sector has grown in leaps and bounds since independence. Security in the country has been a major attraction for tourists all over the world. This imaginary line, which divides the world into the northern and southern hemisphere, crosses through Uganda in the south and can be accessed at Kayawe on Masaka Road. When you reach this point of your journey, there is a guide who will perform for you a series of experiments to prove the presence of the equator. Apparently, when you are in the northern hemisphere, the movement of a plant placed into a basin of moving water will be clockwise. But when you take a few steps away and cross into the southern hemisphere, the movement changes and the plant will now move in an anti-clockwise direction. But when you are in the center, right at the crossing, the plant will move neither in a clockwise nor anti-clockwise direction. It will stay stationary. You can even buy a certificate to show that you have crossed the equator. Blessed with remarkable natural landscapes and a vast experience of flora and fauna, the country boasts of tropical weather throughout the year. The infrastructure in the country is top-notch, with easy access in and out through road and air transport. Entebbe International Airport is located on the shores of the magnificent Lake Victoria, the largest freshwater lake in Africa and the second largest in the whole world. This vast, glistening expanse of water is home to the 84 Sese Islands, whose remote nature has been a consistent tourist attraction over the years due to the ferry rides across the lake and the jungle drives. Bulago is one of the best located islands. With its wide variety of terrain, lush vegetation, and golden sandy beaches, it offers unrivaled serenity and captivating views.
Bulago Island, Uganda's best kept secret. And you know, tourist destination number one, I tell you. Too much fun.
The weather is fantastic, the water is beautiful and warm, the beaches are beautiful and clean. People are warm and friendly. Man, it's a beautiful place to come. If I can come from South Africa, people can come from the rest of the world.
Entebbe, the resort town, is famous for all its beaches and wildlife. The Uganda Wildlife Center is situated in here, and it provides information to about different animals, which include lions, crocodiles, eagles, as well as snakes.
Thank you.
Lake Victoria is also the source of the mighty River Nile. Here in Jinja District, the river begins its 6,000-kilometer journey to the Mediterranean Sea. Other attractions in Jinja include the stunningly beautiful Ntanda Falls, an ideal spot for whitewater rafting.
Good morning, everybody. Okay, it's Joe Broggs out here. We're in the Pearl of Africa. Yes, it's Uganda, and you are about to go rafting on the Mighty White Nile. Okay, the one-day Mighty White Nile. It's one of God's biggest water features. So hang on really tight. It's going to get wet. Whee!
Good fun, everyone swimming in new sport. It's good.
Bungee jumping is another blood-pumping sport practiced here. This 44-meter plunge into the source of the Nile is simply awesome. Jet boating and river surfing also take place here. There's a chance to visit Mavira Forest's nature seventh heaven and true African tropical jungle, home to many plants and animal species. Another major landmark is the Queen Elizabeth National Park, located in southwestern Uganda. With its topography of abundant, breathtaking mosaic-patterned rolling hills with narrow valleys, the park derives its name from the Queen of England, Queen Elizabeth II. At 1,978 square kilometers, the fertile equatorial area is made up of tropical rainforests, lush savanna grasslands, and two lakes. The beauty is simply indescribable, with extensive savanna forests, rivers, and lakes. The park is one of the very few remaining pristine wildlife sanctuaries in the world. The Maramagambo Forest Walks, as well as the launch cruise on the splendid Kazinga Channel with its azure waters teeming with hippopotami, are sight for sore eyes. This 32-kilometer channel links Lake Edward and Lake George and draws a varied range of animals and birds, with the world's largest concentration of hippos and numerous crocodiles. The park is one of the very few remaining pristine wildlife sanctuaries in the world.
I actually grew up in a beautiful part of the United States, and this is in high competition. It's just gorgeous. That's why I wanted to do the tour, just because it's all outside. The weather's great. We actually went through the equator today, which is really cool. Never done that before. What else? The food is really great. The people are amazing. Everybody I've met has just been really, really kind.
I have enjoyed the most seeing the animals, and I'm watching a hippopotamus right now running away, which is very unusual because I didn't think they could run, especially the animals. But in Uganda especially, I have enjoyed the people we've met individually have been quite charming, and the children have been very respectful.
The magnificent Rwenzori Ranges are one of the park's main attractions. Also known as the Mountains of the Moon, they stretch some 80 miles long and are about 30 miles wide. They are known for their vegetation ranging from tropical rainforest through alpine meadows to snow, and for their animal population including forest elephants, several primate species, and many endemic birds. The highest peak of the ranges is Margarita, and it's permanently snow-capped. Many tourists have undertaken this formidable climb for a lifetime experience.
I don't know what is.
This mountain is gives such a unique landscape, what I never saw somewhere else, and that will stay in my mind, and these impressions of, it's not a place where you just can go and visit and see, it's a place you have to, it's a little fight to come here, because it's hard. So not everybody can go just like visiting a museum, and that makes it quite unique as well.
Among the numerous secrets of the Rwenzori region are the famous Sempaya Hot Springs. The springs have a number of outlets, and some of these can be used to boil eggs. Apparently, the springs have genders, male and female, the male springs called Bitende and the female springs called Nyasimbi. The male spring, Bitende, is hotter than the female and boils at 106 degrees centigrade. It is the size of a mini